doing? So I'm actually your MC tonight, but I'm obviously also here, so I thought, I don't want to do the whole, please welcome Dàna, and then I walk off and walk back on, so I just dragged them all up. But thank you so much for coming tonight. We are Dàna, and here to support Dougie MacLean, so we'll just kick things off, and you can hear the rest of the nonsense about the bands later on. Set to start us off there with the wonderful Emma Hill on the pipes. This going to be a really fun night for myself and Laura, even Anna switching fiddles, just remembering what keys we're playing in, so if you hear some sort of noise at any point, it's fine, we'll carry on. But yeah, so a fairly new band we are. We all met in uni, we've just graduated last month from the Conservatoire up in Glasgow studying traditional music. So it took us 4 years, but we finally made a band of some sort, so we're delighted to be here at MOK Fest, making our MOK Fest debut, so hopefully you'll let us back after you hear everything else. But we're going to carry on now. In fact, I'm going to tell you about the band, how it started. I don't know if my mother is... Oh, she is here. Oh, no. So... so we started... has anyone ever been to a pub called The Scallion in Glasgow? It's on Great Western Road. Yes. Well, this is where this band came about, because there was a session in there that our pals were running for about a year or so. So we were there religiously every single Wednesday, 8 till 12, like, we were going to be there, and there was always some sort of, like, hilarity in the corner coming from our table. But unfortunately the session was cancelled around Christmas time, so coming into the new year, there was no more session at the Scallion, but we decided, why should we give up our Wednesday nights in the Scallion just because the session's not there? So instead of the session, we started Wine Time Wednesdays. So this band was indeed formed over a few bottles of wine. I'll not say how many. One, because my mum's up there. Two, because goodness knows. So we're going to play the first set that we put together now, which was for the International Women's Day concert in RCS back in March. So yeah, some fantastic tunes written by some wonderful female fiddle players, and the final tune is written by our very own Anna Robertson on the fiddle, who composed this tune called The 915,
if anyone's gone from Glasgow to Fort William or Skye, it's the bus called 915. So yeah, that's the one I get home. I get off in Fort William, but yeah, it's named after that bus.
There is going to be a lot of that, so get used to it.
Thank you.
song out with a set of tunes I also wrote. It's the only ones I've written in the whole set, I promise. But yeah, these are two tunes I wrote about a trip I took to New Zealand last summer. Has anyone here been to New Zealand? So two tunes, one's written about the South Island and one's written about the North Island, so you'll know they're very different places. The first one's called the Crown Range, which is named after the highest and most dangerous road in New Zealand, near Wanaka in Queenstown, which we took a trip up, and a very scary trip. It was in the winter, or summer, and yeah, it was icy and very steep, and I wrote this tune after that. And then I'm going to go into a tune called Trip to Hahe, which is a little place up in the North Island, up near the Coromandel Coast. A lovely tropical, very, very different to the South Island. So yeah, hope you enjoy these tunes.
Thank you.
pipes. I think it's about time. we're definitely ready for that. Do we have any whiskey drinkers here tonight? Oh, a lot. That's good. This set is for all of you then, everybody in this whole room. We like whiskey, but we love tunes about whiskey. So these are a couple of tunes. The first one is a Strathspey called Welcome the Whiskey Back Again, and a fiddle player called Neil Gow wrote this. Before this, he'd written a tune called Farewell to Whiskey, when whiskey distilling had been stopped for a little while, and this tune was kind of like a yes, we've got our drink back kind of hurrah. And then it goes into another Strathspey, because we also love Strathspeys in Scotland, before finishing with a real, on the pipes. Can't remember what it's called, but it's a great tune. Thank you. sometimes even just like listening to the pipes kind of going that fast, like I feel like I can't breathe right now. I'm like, kind of puts me out of breath as well. So because of that, we're going to slow things down a little bit, and we're going to play a tune called Shaws by John Somerville, who was a tutor of ours in first year at the RCS. So we did this like Celtic Connections concert, and we only managed to do it twice in our 4 years, thanks to the dreaded C word that shall not be mentioned. But this year, myself and Laura over on the Clarsach put together an arrangement of this tune called Shaws, purely because it's lovely, and it's not often that A, you kind of get to work in an orchestral setting in traditional music, and B, that the harp and piano are kind of the focus that actually get to work together at all in traditional music. So yeah, we took this to the big band and we said, can we please do this? And we were like, please, 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 and they let us, so that was nice. So yeah, that was lovely. There was probably about, I don't know, 50 odd of us did that all together. So it might not just be the four of us, but I think it's still just as nice. So yeah, we'll give you this, Shaws by John Somerville. Thank you.
pipes, Emma Hill. And on the classic, Laura Penman.
Unfortunately, we have come to our last set. I heard like one person there. Unfortunately, we have come to our last set. Oh, thanks, guys. So we're going to finish off with a set of reels and jigs. And I'm going to let Eleanor tell you a little bit about the first tune in a wee second. But just before I do so, I just want to thank you all so much for buying your tickets and coming out tonight. I mean, obviously, MOK Fest and anything like this wouldn't be possible if it wasn't for, you know, the people that are here in front of us and supporting the town and supporting the festival. So thank you so much. And thank you to Jim on sound and... getting a big thumbs up from him. He's my favourite sound man this weekend. And to everyone at the MOK Fest committee and to Ian. And yeah, just thanks to everyone here at the Heritage Centre as well. So yeah, we'll finish off with a wee tune. I'll let Eleanor tell you a little bit about the first one.
So I wrote the first tune kind of after the aforementioned pub that we all formed the band in. Lots of wine. Lots of laughs, it's all fine. But it's called Scallywags after the scallion. And aye, there's a wee ABBA inspired bit. And anyone that spots it, come see us for a prize. Who knows what the prize is? We haven't decided yet. But aye, someone, listen out for it.
Yeah, it's well hidden and no one's found it yet. We've said that every single gig. We've had like 5 gigs this month or something. Not one person has found it. So is there any like real, you know, die-hard ABBA fans in here? Good luck.
Thank you.